Hi everyone, welcome back. I hope you are keeping healthy and safe. Let us continue with our topic, advertising media. In the previous videos, we have already discussed print media, electronic or broadcast media, and direct mail advertising. Today we are going to discuss out of home advertising, which includes outdoor and transit advertising. Let us directly move to it. Out of home media includes outdoor media and transit media. So if you are a student of marketing or advertising, and if you are attempting any paper, you have to write both of these. So let us study one by one what is outdoor media and transit media. So outdoor media means that the advertisement will appear on billboards, street furniture, etc. Right? So now you can see that billboards are no more the usual old billboards. There are a lot of variety because of the technology. You have a lot of options. You can show a lot of creativity through by using the technology in your outdoor media also. We will see this is one of the billboard, and it is very much appropriate to the current scenario that we have to be safe, and we all are together in this, and we have to keep using the mask. So innovation in technology has, you know, revolutionized the outdoor media. You have 2D, 3D, LED billboards, you know, we will see in examples later that how innovative the advertisers are with their outdoor media. So let us see some example. Also, we will discuss later these things as to in the ethical and legal issues of advertising, that there were Supreme Court restrictions against various forms of outdoor media. Because like, see, if you are driving and if there is a huge big billboard which is very attractive, it could attract the attention and it could divert the driver's attention from the road, which could be hazardous. So there were certain restrictions against the various forms of outdoor advertising, which we will discuss in the later videos. So let us stick to outdoor media now. See, in the next series of video, we will discuss how the advertisement should look, that is advertising copy. So advertising copy is different for different type of advertising media, because the requirements are so. So you can see this is one of the billboard in which you can see minimum content, and you can see the name of the company, you can see the logo of the company, you can see a major tagline, and the product is embedded in the logo itself. So this is one kind of outdoor media, which is the billboard. This is another one, the posters and billboards you see outside the shops. Then this is another one, the posters and the banners on the bus stops. You see there is light also, which helps you at places where there is no street light, and if you have banners, they won't be visible, but if you embed the light with your banner, it would be visible at any place. Okay, then there was this very famous and mysterious billboard that Netflix is a joke. I'll leave the entire article in the description below so you can go through it. And this meant that it was placed strategically at different famous places of Hollywood, and it meant that Netflix is coming up with the comedy series. So Netflix is a joke. So it looks simple, but then it generated curiosity as to what does it mean. So the company may have different strategies. It could be colorful, it could be plain black and white, it could be a catchy one-liner tagline, and that is how you can create interest and gain the attention of the consumers. So let us talk about the advantages and the limitations of outdoor media. As you can understand that thousands and millions of people are commuting every day on daily basis, and so these billboards and posters are visible to the commuters on daily basis. Then geographical flexibility. You can select as to where do you want to place the billboards, at what part of the road or the route. And so if your product is available at a particular mall or in a particular market, placing your billboards on the way to that market would be a very good option. But if you are placing your posters or billboards at a place where your shop is very distant, does not make any sense, or which doesn't come in the route. So geographical flexibility and selectivity is very much possible with billboards. Then, as I told you, creativity, a lot of creativity is possible. Again, I'll leave in the description an article which you can see as to how the companies have gone creative with their outdoor advertising. Then awareness and reminder. See, when you are traveling again and again on the same route and you see a particular billboard, you get aware about that product, and if that product is already famous, it is an efficient reminder because it is visible to you every day. So that is how outdoor advertising media helps in creating awareness and reminder. And cost effective, if you see, cost per person is low as compared to other mediums for billboards. Then waste coverage. Everyone who's traveling and seeing your billboard is not your potential customer. So that is how we have a lot of waste coverage in outdoor media. Then, because it is like the people are moving, they are not going to stop and read your message all the time on the roadside. So you can write only limited things. If you are writing a lot of things and placing your billboard across a highway, it will make no sense because people cannot read it from the distance, A. And secondly, on the busy road, you are not going to stop your cars or scooters and see what is written. So you have minimal copy. You may have a big logo, name, and the product image which you generally find in billboards around you. So the best way to imagine how a billboard is be aware of your environment. आप देखिए आपके आस पास जो billboards लगे होते हैं वो कैसे होते हैं. Then you will understand that you will not find billboards with lot of written content which is like possible in newspapers and magazines. So that is then you have to select as to when you will select billboard as a company. So if you don't want to give a huge message, long message, then billboards are good for you. But if you want to write a lot of things, then billboard is not a good medium for you. Then next is wear out. Because of the rain, sun, dhoop, barish, aapka billboard jo hai wo over the period of time wear out, kharab hota rehta hai. And last one is measurement problem. Measurement problem because aap kaise measure karenge as to if every day so many people are passing and seeing passing through that billboard, how many of them noticed your billboard, how many of them gained interest in your billboard is a little difficult task to measure. So that is the measurement problem in outdoor media. So this was about outdoor media, which included the furniture, street furniture, and the billboards. Now we move on to the second part, which is transit advertising. Transit advertising means advertising through commercial transport services like bus, taxis, metro, train, planes, etc. You must have seen while you are traveling in metro, metro ke bahar, metro ke andar, or while you are traveling in buses, buses ke bahar, companies ke naam, product ka picture dikhai deta hai. Sometimes buses ke andar bhi dikhai deta hai. And then in planes also, in taxis also, you have different brands which are being promoted. So that is transit advertising. So these are some of the examples. You can see the buses all covered with the Snapdeal. And this is the metro. It is a common feature now. This is advertising inside the bus, you can see. These are some of the creative examples. You will find a lot of examples which are 3D and which immediately attracts your attention. So this is Coke. Then this is also common in India. You will find autos ke peeche, rickshaws ke peeche bhi lagaya hota advertisement. Right. So I hope it is clear with these examples that what is transit advertising. Matlab jo vehicles ke through aap advertise kar rahe ho, andar vehicles ke laga ke, bahar vehicles ke laga ke aapke advertisement, you are promoting your product. So let us see how this transit advertising helps you and what are the limitations again. So exposure, इट इज़ वाइड एक्सपोजर. आप लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर यू नो यूजिंग पब्लिक ट्रांसपोर्ट एंड इवन द टैक्सीज एंड कैब्स एंड यू आर इफ यू आर पुटिंग योर एडवर्टीजमेंट देयर इट इज़ रीचिंग टू अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल. देन फ्रीक्वेंसी, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू आर ट्रैवलिंग फ्रॉम पॉइंट ए टू पॉइंट बी एवरी डे फ्रॉम से साउथ डेली टू नॉर्थ डेली टू योर कॉलेज एंड यू आर यूजिंग वन मेट्रो, यू आर यूजिंग दैट मेट्रो ऑलमोस्ट ऑन एवरी डे बेसिस. और इफ़ यू आर गोइंग टू योर ऑफिस, यू आर गोइंग टू योर ऑफिस 5 days अ वीक एंड यू आर एक्सपोज टू दैट पर्टिकुलर एड एवरी डे, राइट? सो द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ एडवर्टीजमेंट इज हाई. देन टाइमलीनेस, ओके, यू कैन प्लेस योर एड्स वेरी स्ट्रैटेजिकली. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू आर ट्रैवलिंग टू अ पर्टिकुलर मॉल वाया मेट्रो एंड देर इज़ अ पर्टिकुलर शॉप देयर, if that shop is placing the ad in the metro and if the person is going to mall for shopping, so it would be a very timely and appropriate place to put your ad, because while going en route my mind is in shopping and I want to shop for a particular thing and that particular shop is having some discount or some scheme and then you are advertising in that particular metro which is going to the mall. So, you know, it is very timely and appropriate place to advertise. Then geographical selectivity, again, if your shop is in a particular place, you can advertise on the vehicles which are in that particular place, which are roaming in that particular place, the metros which are going towards that place, and you can avoid other vehicles in other part of the city or the town or the state. Then it is less costly as compared to again other mediums like television and newspaper. Per person cost is less in transit, less for transit advertising. Next one is image. See, negatives, we are starting with negatives, or you can say the shortcomings. First one is image. If you see a luxury product at the back of a rickshaw or at the back of a truck, it will not suit the image. So advertising on vehicles is not appropriate for all kinds of product. If you are a luxury product, it is not a good way. If you want to do some social advertising and pass on a social message for a particular class of our masses, then it is a good medium, you can say. But then if you are advertising for a premium products, it is not good. If like you can't see BMW being advertised at the back of a rickshaw or a bus or a cab, so it doesn't suit all types of product and service. Next one is again waste coverage. All the people traveling on daily basis or maybe occasionally also, you can count, have an approximate idea as to how many people are doing up and down every day, but how many people out of them are seeing your ads, are your potential customer, or have paid attention to your ad is difficult task to do. Then creative limitations. Companies are of course becoming more and more creative every day, as you saw the picture of Coke on the bus. But yes, of course there are creative limitations if you compare it with television. Audio visuals nahin hote hain, and then you have certain limitations when you are putting your ad on a auto rickshaw or on a bus, so you have to design it accordingly that it looks good also and is attractive also. And again, you cannot put a lot of content on the outer part. If you are doing right, if you are doing so, nobody is going to stop and read on the bus. Or if you are like standing on the bus stop and if a bus is passing, you will not be able to read anything. So it is just like a passing message. You just have a big brand name or maybe the celebrity endorser and the image of your product and service, and that's it. A lot of content cannot go into it. And last one is mood of audience, of course, which is a limitation in all kind of medias, that it depends on the audience as to how much attention they are paying. So if I'm traveling every day in the metro and I'm standing in the metro for 1 hour, I'm already tired and I don't want to pay attention to any ads. So even if your ad is in right front of me, I'm not bothered about it. Or maybe I am listening to the songs on radio and So you cannot really say as to all the people who are traveling are paying attention to your ads. It is a limitation on the part of customers as humans that we do not pay attention to ads, right? So that is all about transit advertising. I hope this media is clear. So we talked about out of home advertising. Out of home advertising mein aata hai outdoor advertising or transit advertising. Outdoor mein aa jata hai billboards, aapke furniture jo aapke park mein benches and chairs pade hote hain us pe bhi likhe hote hain, एडवर्टीजमेंट छपे हुए होते हैं. एंड देन ट्रांजिट में हो गया वहीकुलर, जिसमें वहीकल्स के अंदर और बाहर एडवर्टीजमेंट्स दी होती हैं. सो आई होप द टॉपिक इज क्लियर. इफ़ यू हैव एनी क्वेरीज प्लीज़ फील फ्री टू राइट इन द कॉमेंट सेक्शन बिलो. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ गुड डे.